is I, Teutonic Penguin. It's been a minute since my last upload like this, but today I'd like to show you a Viking kit that I've been slowly working on a bit over a year now, adding to it a piece at a time. Most of it I made myself, either at home or at a shop at my college. For the pieces I did not make, I will provide information on where I got them, in case any of you are working on a Viking kit and are missing a couple pieces. Starting off with the soft kit, I'm wearing some woolen winningas, which I purchased from a very talented seamstress on Etsy. I'll provide a link to her shop in the description. Next, I'm wearing some very simple linen trousers with hidden knee protection for sport combat. The linen tunic I wear, I made with help from a friend, as well as the hand-stitched hood, and a woolen cloak, which is actually an army blanket, which I purchased from Amazon for around 20 bucks. On my belt, I have a leather pouch, which I hand-stitched, a small Saxon knife, which I made in a rush for an event, a bearded axe I ground from a roofing hatchet, and a Viking long sax, which I adapted from an old machete blade. The steel is still strong, so it's alright for combat. Now I'll start putting on the armor for the kit, starting with a gambeson. Now, there's a lot of speculation whether or not the Vikings used gambeson, as there's no surviving examples from that time period. However, I wear a gambeson because it makes combat safer by softening the blows, as many of you know. This one I had custom made from black linen. The reason I chose black, even though it's not a very historical color, is to keep it from staining from wearing mail. Later, I added the leather edging, hand-stitched all the way around, on the collar and the sleeves. Next up, we have mail. This shirt is made by Albesta. Very good prices, a lot of options. I'll provide a link for that shop in the description. Alright. Next up, I'm going to be putting on the lamellar. This lamellar is made by me, totally from scratch, out of tempered steel. First, I put on the tasset belt, if you will. I intend to attach these directly to the suit, but for now this works. Okay, next, we have bazoo bands. Now, I know these are not period, however, the extra elbow protection and splints are very necessary for sport combat. I made these out of 8-ounce veg tan leather and used splints made from an industrial bandsaw blade, which turn out to be very, very hard. Broke about a dozen drill bits trying to get through this stuff. You can actually purchase very similar bazoo bands off of Wolfland, which is where I got the idea for the pattern. Made a couple changes, like making the elbow cover more of the joint, and cutting away some of the material at the wrist to allow better mobility. Alright, nearing the end, I wear this small arm splint for extra protection on the upper arm. I made this with the leftover material from the bazoo bands. Now I'll put on the belt. also wear these mail mitts, which I also got from All Best Stuff, same as the mail shirt. They're padded on the inside and provide decent protection in combat. I'm also going to put on my bowling hood, as it adds a bit of color to the kit. Again, I stitched this by hand. The pattern is very simple, and you can find many tutorials on how to make one on YouTube. And finally, the last piece, the crowning jewel, is the helmet. I designed and crafted the helmet completely from scratch, loosely based on a Vendel-style helmet. It features a steel bar grill for full facial protection and support combat, made from a 15-gauge higher-carbon steel, very well padded on the inside. That is my full 10th century Viking / Varangian kit. Took a lot of work to put together, but I was pretty pleased with the end result, despite some minor inaccuracies. This is a lot lighter than the kits that I usually wear, so it's been nice to fight without so much extra weight. This kit has very, very good mobility, as there's hardly anything hindering my movement. I hope you all enjoyed the video. If you have any questions about armor or weapons, feel free to ask. As always, comment, subscribe, and thanks for watching.